But then when you read some of my stuff, you saw that it was imbued with research and stuff similar to what
It was not fluff. When I thought that you did fluff, I thought you dealt with media, the talk show circuit kind of fluff, but that your books I've never read. And so I had no idea what your writing was like. So that's why when you wrote this book, I was like, wow.
Which because book?
This, hold it up. Amplify your media. What is it? Amplify your media presence. Amplify your brand. When you wrote that, I was so impressed with the, because it's not written in a scholarly tone, but it's written in a very sophisticated business tone. And I wasn't sure because, the next Instagram video I might see of you, you might be dancing, or the next one I might see you. You might be talking about Kanye, or I don't know, whatever it is that you're talking about, right? So how do you decide what you want to talk about, and who is your market?
It depends upon the platform.
Mm-hmm.
Now, for example, you and I always talk about, well, we have to look a certain way when we're up in front of a corporate group. We're not going to be wearing.
Not going to wear this shirt. Yeah.
Yeah. Or braless straps or anything that looks too crazy. Uh-huh. You cut back on your earrings. I love to wear dangling earrings no matter where I go. Mm-hmm. So some of the things. I mean, and our personalities are our personalities. But I see that you draw down your personality usually. Whereas I am who I am all the time, wild and zany and crazy. And yet I still have the base of research with a PhD from NYU. I mean, I can't get away from that.
Right.
So I have found in studying all the great leaders of the world as part of my doctorate, I have found that to do, for example, comedy, you have to be so on top of things, so bright and so well informed that your zingers come out when they should. And you are studying timing as well so that they do come out at the right time, et cetera, et cetera. So I look at this all in my career as style flexing according to the platform. Now, I can't talk about research stuff on Instagram, and TikTok is a new thing for me and I am just learning it and I don't know what I'm doing, but it's fun. So my whole attitude is I always want to do stuff that I haven't done before so I could learn and expand myself. And the
but
more
I got a question as you say that.
More, but the more I learn, the more I apply to different scenarios.
Well, and I agree with that. And I'm wondering if your TikTok, if you could still have the same message delivered in a different way, but just instead of talking about Kanye or whatever, if you can't, what could you be talking about?
Well, okay.
Your book, but in a way like presentation. No, that's not the market.
They're not interested in that. However,
but they're taking legal advice. They're taking stock advice.
So they say. I know. I really have to learn more about that. For example, on Instagram, I do not understand Instagram at all. Every time I post, my numbers go down. I mean, it's the craziest thing.
I think with a lot of social media sites, the things that'll turn people away, I found, is if there's lots of hashtags, lots of, like too much stuff. You know what I mean? And I think it's all about sharing what other people do more than what we do. And so, I hardly ever post about my book, for example, but I might write about curiosity. Or I think with me, with my radio show, I think it's about me because I'm in it, but it's more often about other people showcasing what they've done.
Oh, definitely. Your radio show is all about the other people, but you always use yourself as an example of what you've experienced, and that draws your the attention to you at that point in a very humble, beautiful way. Now, last night, I was up till 1 o'clock in the morning trying to figure out some TikTok thing. It was the stupidest, craziest thing, but I got it out.
What was it that you couldn't figure out? Because I want to know.
Well, I'm just looking to figure out the dynamics of how to use TikTok and who makes it and who doesn't. I mean, I just don't know that yet. Maybe I'll never know that because, with Facebook and with Instagram, they put you in Facebook jail if you say something that they don't like about. I mean, I've had friends who have gone into Facebook jail, but no, seriously. And
that's mostly political, isn't it? That they cut you off?
No, it's not.
Oh, really?
It's not. You know, women get.
I'm not that interesting that I get into Facebook jail, I guess.
Well, like women get together and they start male bashing. We don't do that. I don't do that. Because I'm a man. I just don't do that. Yeah. But women do. And one woman got placed into Facebook jail. Or maybe it was Instagram, whatever it was. She got placed into jail for 24 hours because she posted some male bashing thing. And I wish that on some of the Instagrams, they would start scrutinizing some of the demeaning things that are out there, body shaming other women. I have made statements along those lines. I can't stand it. And I don't want to see our children growing up seeing that, et cetera, et cetera. But last night I was talking about, and again, this is to show you how research-based I always am. Last night I was talking about how a study had been done that showed that men with higher levels of testosterone are usually not such great partners. And there's a correlation between their pitch, like voice pitch, and their promiscuity rates.
You were talking about James Earl Jones. Was that the one? I was.
Yeah.
I watch your stuff.
You do. Please like them. I need like.
I do. I think I did. I meant to if I didn't.
Well, whatever you do, please like and follow me, please.
I will.
This is new for me, so I'm just learning. Anyway, so of course, I use James Earl Jones with that fabulous baritone that he has, but it's always based on a study or something that I have drawn from my own research that is constant. I mean, I don't stop researching every single month. Like you have your thing under the aegis of curiosity. Well, I have my thing under the aegis of research. I'm always researching.
Yeah.
And so what I bring to the table that nobody else that I have seen on TikTok is doing is adding the research base to my commentary about relationships and about how we love, how we interrelate, how we communicate, et cetera, et cetera. So that's how it all comes together. And every single thing I do, I know that this book doesn't look like any of my other books because it doesn't have a relationship concept in it. However, it's all relationship based. When we are having a relationship with the audience, that is what is going to sell our product, our brand,